This is the all-new Mazda CX-30 front-wheel drive sport variant that we have here in the Philippines. It's fresh from the factory, and it's the latest subcompact crossover SUV in Mazda's lineup. Today, I'm going to go around this car, and I'm going to review it. Let's do this. I'd like to extend a special shout out and thank you to Mazda Makati. They gave me this opportunity to do a review of the CX-30 in their very showroom. Now, Mazda Makati is a premier dealership of Mazda Philippines. And if you are in the area of Makati or the neighboring cities, you can come over and pay them a visit and experience the top-notch quality of their service and hospitality. Now let's go on to the review. In my recent review of the Mazda CX-3, I mentioned that the Philippines will be getting only a single variant. That's to make way for the debut of this all-new CX-30, of which the Philippines will be getting four variants. We have the base level front-wheel drive Pro variant, which you could tell by looking at its 16-inch wheels. Then we have the range-topping all-wheel drive signature variant. And below that, we have the all-wheel drive sport variant. And finally, we have the front-wheel drive sport variant that we have here. Now for this review, we are going to focus only on the front-wheel drive sport variant. The Mazda CX-30 may be a subcompact crossover, but it is based on the all-new Mazda 3. So that makes it a little bit bigger than its little brother, the CX-3, which is based off the Mazda 2 or the Demio in other markets. Now, this CX-30 follows the same evolved Kodo design language that we've already seen in the new Mazda 3. That gives this crossover that smooth, flowy design that we've all come to love about this Evolve Kodo design. However, there is one tiny niggle that can be found in the CX-30's design that you cannot find in the Mazda 3. And that is this. We have larger than life body claddings surrounding the lower half of the CX-30. Now, this is a love it or hate it feature of the design of the CX-30. Some people would love it because it gives off a little bit of that macho, rugged SUV vibe, but other people would hate it because they would think that, what in the world is this? Did the Mazda designers of the CX-30 decide to take a coffee break in the middle of finishing the design and just decided to slap on a ton of body cladding at the lower half of the vehicle? But either way, it serves as a functional piece, at least to remind you that the CX-30 is not just a Mazda 3 on stilts, but rather it is still a crossover SUV with rugged intentions, and you can take it out for some light off-roading. One of the differences of the Evolve Kodo design language of Mazda versus the previous Kodo design language is the front grille. Just like the new Mazda 3, the CX-30 sports a blacked out grille with the Mazda logo in the center. This gives the illusion that the Mazda logo is floating in a sea of black in front of the grille. It's a pretty good rendering of the design, and it gives that premium upscale look to the Mazda CX-30. For headlights, the front-wheel drive Sport already comes with LED headlights, and it is also adaptive headlights. That means that wherever your steering wheel is pointed, the headlights will follow. This improves your night safety on the road and makes sure that you will always see wherever you want to go. Looking at the stance and the height of the CX-30, although it is an SUV crossover, it is not that tall. It's actually almost car-like, and I would even say that it looks like a Mazda 3 that has been lifted, or a Mazda 3 hatchback that has been lifted. And maybe that is the main reason why Mazda decided to incorporate these large body claddings to make sure that you will not mistake it for a Mazda 3 hatchback. Moving on to the wheels, the front wheel drive sport variant has the same wheel size as the all wheel drive variants in the stable. We have here 18-inch wheels and it's wrapped in 215/55 R18 tires. The base level Pro variant gets smaller 16-inch wheels, and that's probably one of the main differentiating factors that you could tell that your CX-30 is the base variant versus the front wheel drive sport and the all wheel drive models. Moving on to the engine, you will notice that the words on the engine cover says Skyactiv G. That's because our CX-30s here in the Philippines still do not get the Skyactiv X engine. Now, the Skyactiv X would have been a great engine here because it is a gas engine that has a diesel fuel economy. Now, we will still have to make do with the Skyactiv G, which is still a decent 2-liter engine that is good for 155 horsepower and 200 newton meters of torque. The CX-30 also comes with a G-Vectoring Control Plus feature. Now, this helps maintain the stability of your car while you're cornering, while you're braking and accelerating by making millisecond throttle input adjustments to your engine, thus keeping you safer and more stable. All CX-30 variants in the country also get that iStop feature. Now, iStop is something that will shut down your engine when you come to a complete stop and restart it immediately once you want to start going. It's supposed to save you as much as 5% in terms of fuel economy, but in real world traffic here, especially in Metro Manila, where we are practically stopping every couple of meters, the iStop feature is something that I personally would just turn off because it might risk destroying my battery, my capacitor, and pretty much the engine. So if you are driving in an area where traffic is still within human reason, then the iStop feature is a great feature. But if you are driving in hellish Manila traffic, it is something that I would rather just turn off. Moving to the back of the CX-30, you could see that it also follows all of its stablemates tailpipes. It comes with dual sporty tailpipes, and these are real tailpipes, so kudos to Mazda for that. Now, as we open the trunk, you will see that the CX-30 sports a decent 430 liters of trunk space, and that's with the second row seats still usable. You could fit medium-sized luggage here, maybe a couple of small bags as well. Now, you also have this tonneau cover which keeps the privacy of your stuff, and if you would need some more trunk space, you could always tumble down the second row seats to expand your trunk space further. If you will look at the CX-30's key fob, it's a regular key fob with the logo of Mazda right there, and at the back there is an open blank space. Now, if you're looking for the lock and unlock button, it can be found to the side. No, not that side, it's on this side where you'll find the lock and unlock button. But if you'll notice, there is no panic button or find your car button because CX-30 owners are too refined to even panic when they are looking for their car. Since the CX-30 is marketed as a vehicle for starting families, let's take a look at the comfort of the back seat to find out just how it will accommodate those starting families. Okay, seated at the second row, the back seat, It can comfortably accommodate somebody of my height and build. I am 5'6", but if you are upwards of 5'10", you will find that the knee room might be a bit cramped and the headroom as well. But if you're below 5'10", the back seat is a totally livable space for somebody like you. Now, looking at the size of the back seat, you could fit 3 adults in a pinch, but it wouldn't be comfortable. In fact, if you are 3 adults, I would not want to be that third guy who's seated at the center, because you have your center tunnel on your leg area, which will impinge on your leg room, and you also have the aircon vents aimed squarely at you. Looking at the back area, you will see another quirk that Mazda seems to be fond of when it comes to some of their cars in the lineup. You see, the back of the passenger seat has a pocket where you can put some stuff in, but if you look at the driver's seat, there are no pockets to be found. This is one of Mazda's ways of saving a couple of bucks by deleting the driver's back pocket and still putting a passenger's back pocket. Now, the mystery if it's the same for right-hand drive vehicles still remains unsolved. Now let's go to the interior of the CX-30. When you open the door, the first thing you'll notice is the black leather seats. The CX-30 across all variants sport black leather seats with this contrast white stitching that gives it a bit more of that sporty, racy vibe. The center console is also in leather, and if you'll notice, it also has dual contrast stitching found in the center. That is a very nice aesthetic touch for the CX-30. The front wheel drive sport variant does not come with power seats. However, both passenger and driver have manual adjustments for their seats, which is not really a deal breaker. Sitting on the driver's seat, you are greeted by a standard Mazda steering wheel with your infotainment and Bluetooth calling controls right here, and you also have your standard cruise control controls right here. Now, the first thing that you will notice here is the premium materials they use for the interior. You have here a beautiful dashboard that follows the same dashboard design as the new Mazda 3. You've got contrast stitching, and you've got premium soft touch materials and leather at the side of the dashboard. Now, looking at the infotainment system, you will note that the infotainment system has been recessed into the dashboard, unlike most other previous offerings of Mazda, where the infotainment screen is like a wart that is jutting out of the dashboard. Here it has been luxuriously integrated, and it is now a better design. It is also a larger screen at 8 inches. The front wheel drive sport variant also comes with dual zone automatic climate control. And if you'll note here, you have a 6-speed automatic transmission with sport mode. And that is something that I would have to give a thumbs up to Mazda, because they still haven't jumped on the CVT bandwagon, and they still provide their sporty drivers with a 6-speed automatic transmission that comes with a sport mode. Now, to up the ante even further, the CX-30 comes with paddle shifters. You will note here, there are paddle shifters hiding behind the steering wheel to give you a more engaging drive when you take your CX-30 out for a spin. So kudos, Mazda, for staying true to your racing heritage and not going for CVT. Heading down here, you will have your usual control knob for your Mazda infotainment system. You have an electronic parking brake right here with an auto brake hold feature, which pretty much holds the brake for you. You can remove your feet from the brake pedal, and when you step on the gas, it will automatically just disengage. Now, if you notice, there are no cup holders to be found inside the CX-30, because having exposed cup holders is something that is so plebeian, it's tacky. You need to have hidden cup holders, and for the CX-30 we have exactly that. Behind this wrapping, white wrapping material, you have a glossy black cover, and if you pop this open, you will now have access to a couple of cup holders in the middle. That is a classy way of hiding your cup holders. While resting my arm on the center console, I note the softness of the leather, and you will see the dual contrast stitching found in the center, which gives it a very sporty vibe. But the great thing about this center console is how you open it. Typically, if you are in a regular vehicle, you just get the latch and just pop it open. But if you try to do that in the CX-30, you might damage your center console. That's because you have to lift the opening clip and you'll have to slide it back, and that way you will now have access to a small area in your center console. You could even park your smartphone here while it is charging, because the USB port and the 12-volt charger can also be found inside. Now, to fully open it, you have to grab onto the latch and lift it up. And that gives you access to a cavernous storage space here. It's not big enough to hide the laptop, but it is decently sized. And you have your 12-volt charger found here. And you also have a USB port as well for your Apple CarPlay or Android Auto duties. To close it, you just have to bring it back and slide it forward. But by doing so, you still leave this gap open. To fully close it, you have to lift the lock and slide it forward. And there you have it. That's how you close your center console. Here's another proof that Mazda is always thinking about its passengers and customers and making their vehicles as human-centric as possible. So you have your center console here, and as I mentioned, you can slide it back a little bit to reveal a small space. Now, since the USB port is found here and a 12-volt charger port is also found there, you can charge your gadgets. But while charging your gadgets, you don't want your cell phone to just be hanging around wherever. So they integrated this feature into the center console, where you can slightly and partially open it, and while you're charging, you can just park your cell phone right there. You will notice that there is a small plastic stopper that can help keep your cell phone in place. So this is a great way to keep your phones out of the way while it's connected to Apple CarPlay or Android Auto, or while you are charging it at the same time. Looking at the climate control, you will notice that you have dual zone automatic climate control for the CX-30, and I love how they integrated the aircon vents on the passenger side. You will see here that the vents are cleanly integrated underneath the top dashboard, the upper dashboard, and it gives off that premium European vibe. I normally just find this in European cars. The vents are not jutting out as if it's an afterthought by the designers. Instead, Mazda even thought about how they will place the aircon vents in such a way that you will be reminded you are in a premium Japanese car. Now let's start the engine to take a look at the instrument panel. Upon startup, you are greeted by the CX-30 wordings, and you have here pretty much a standard instrument panel. You have your tachometer, your speedometer, and your temperature and fuel gauges to the side. Now, they also integrated your information screen right in the center of your speedometer, and it says there that I'm already low on fuel because this is a showroom unit. You also have your fuel economy gauge right here, and you have other stuff like this is how much further you can reach with your current fuel in the tank. Right now it indicates that I can still travel for 13 kilometers before I run out of fuel. The CX-3D is also equipped with the backing up camera. It is standard for all 2020 models. However, it does not come with a 360-degree view camera. If you want the 360-degree view where you can see everywhere around your car, then you'll have to pony up and go up to the all-wheel drive variants of the CX-3D. For audio duties, the CX-3D in front-wheel drive sport variant comes with an 8-speaker Mazda Harmonic Acoustics system. What is Harmonic Acoustics? This is Mazda's way of tuning the audio system of their vehicles such that they even removed the speakers on the doors. That way, there is no holes where outside noise can come in. This improves the ambience inside the CX-3D, which makes you have a better oral experience akin to a studio setup. There you have it. That is the Mazda CX-3D front-wheel drive sport variant. With this vehicle, Mazda has achieved their goal of becoming a premium and even a luxury Japanese car brand. Now, how much does this premium vehicle cost? This front-wheel drive sport variant retails for 1,790,000 pesos. Now, if you're thinking that that's a lot of money to pay for a subcompact crossover, remember that the build quality, the premium materials, and the safety features that you will find in the CX-3D is something that you can only find in premium and luxury European brands that also offer subcompact crossovers. However, you will not pay that European premium subcompact crossover price when it comes to the CX-3D. Now, who is this car for? The CX-3D are for those who are looking for a premium luxury experience without paying that luxury price. And they also have a starting family and they need a vehicle that will meet and fulfill their starting family's needs while giving them that air of luxury and premium experience at the same time. Once again, guys, thank you for watching one of my car reviews. If you like this review, hit that like button. If you love my videos, my car reviews, and my Miata videos, please subscribe to my channel. Hit that like button. Send some comments down below. Tell me what you think about the CX-3D. Is it really worthy of going against these European subcompact crossovers already? Anyway, I will see you again in the next video. Bye-bye.